We're with wrestling legend Dan Gable, Kyle Martin here, and it is an honor for me personally. I grew up a high school wrestler in Colorado and idolized this guy. Didn't get to Iowa very often to watch him wrestle coach at the University of Iowa. I did get to see a couple of times Coach Gable, but it's an honor, and the reason that he's in Marshalltown is he is going to be here on September 23rd at 2 o'clock at the Marshalltown Library talking about, you've got a couple of books, right? Mm-hmm. Is that right? And this is one of them.
This is the first one.
Okay.
It's basically a wrestling life, but it's a wrestling life one. There is a wrestling life two. So we'll have both of them available.
Okay. And can you talk a little bit about is this a biography or is it life lessons?
No, you could read one chapter and put it down, and you could go to the next one a week later, 2 weeks later. Each one of them is individual. Each one of them is unique. And the first is actually probably the best order is one, book one, and then book two. The first one's more like just talks about my childhood, talks about my life growing up, talks about my high school days, talks about the influential people. But it's in chapters. And, it's a quick read, but it's an entertaining read. I don't hold much back.
Okay.
And, and it's not all of fun and games either. There's some tragedy in there.
Right.
And with that, with my sister getting murdered, it was one of those things that you had to work through. And if you didn't work through it, it's going to be a difficult time for you. I mean, I could say the same thing for what's going on in Marshalltown right now,
right,
just with the tornado and what's going on the East Coast. People are going to have to shape up or...
Yeah,
you're going to be going the wrong direction. So, it's going to be fun. But I think book two is more about, it's a little more in depth. It's actually kind of, it's easy reading and it has each chapter, but it's more like lessons that it's good for everybody, but at all levels. And that's what I like about it. But I keep it entertaining. And I keep the other one entertaining too.
Dan, at an early age, did you realize you were good? I mean, we were talking off air a little bit about wrestling and how I remember when I started and we were talking about losing so much. I don't think I won a match my first year at all.
Wow.
But I kept with it, and it's a tough sport. Did you realize at a really young age that this was something you could excel at?
Didn't really realize it. It just was happening. And because I was in multi-sports, it was one of these things that you just didn't do year round like they do now somewhat. But I think the multi-sport kept me going a long way. And then once I got to a certain level, I realized that I wasn't going to be a great professional football player or basketball player or a baseball player. But I had that feeling, or I had that drive, or the body type, or the mentality to be good on the wrestling mat, even though it wasn't always perfect at the beginning. But it got a lot more perfect as I continued to focus in on the sport. But that was, once I was turned sophomore in high school, although I gave up a lot of the other sports. I follow them all, but kind of focused in, and then I made different commitments at each level, and they were always stronger, so that helped me stay at the top of the game.
Yeah, I think to set goals is probably important. You talked a little bit about that. Did you have a goal to be, to win this many state titles at the high school level, or did you have a goal to win this many NCAA championships, or 1972 to win a gold medal in Munich? Did you have a goal like that?
Yeah, I was probably winning Olympic gold when I was in junior high. And so it's like, maybe I've exaggerated it. Maybe 10th grade, 11th grade, maybe high school.
Okay.
Just because I was still doing other sports then and focusing on home runs and touchdowns and swimming and winning state. Actually, I won a state championship when I was at the YMCA in swimming. So, it's pretty interesting that, that you kind of take things on and you take them on at the proper time. They they elevate you. Mm-hmm. So, you know, a lot of state champions out there. I was an undefeated state champion three times. That's the only chances that I had to wrestle. But then you go to college, but there was a lot of people right around you that were the same. And again, I separated myself because I kept becoming more disciplined than the rest. Mm-hmm. And just making them little edges count. Plus, I loved it.
Yeah.
I really did. And by that, I mean, I enjoyed my training. I loved everything about the sport of wrestling, believe it or not.
Yeah.
People say, well, did you cut any weight or anything? Well, I don't call it cutting weight, but I call it weight management. But at the same time, I really enjoyed it, believe it or not.
I saw a biography on you on ESPN, and it said, like, in college, you had a date. You went out on a date, you went to a film, but you actually left the film early because you had to go train.
Oh, yeah, I did that, too.
That is discipline.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's one of these things. And one time during college, I took a girl out. I said one time.
Yeah.
You know, so you're there quite a few years. But, you know, and when I got home, it was, oh, my gosh, I got early morning practice.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was the last date.
That was... how long did it take you to write this book? I see that, is it Scott Schulte co-wrote the book with you?
Yeah, and then book two is Kyle Klingman, who runs the Gable Museum in Waterloo, Iowa,
sure.
Actually. So how long it took me? I focused in on this little porch down in Florida in the month of January, because I kind of go down there with my wife and have this little condo down there. And I wrote it in January a couple years ago, and then maybe 3 years ago, and then 2 years ago, I went with the Wrestling Life too. And that month, I just focused every day. That didn't mean it was done in a month, but
right.
That my bulk of writing was probably a month into this and a month into the other one, so.
So, okay, so you actually wrote this book. So many people let other people tell their life story. I think it's awesome that you wanted to get your story out and not leave it to, you know, the types in Hollywood or New York Publishing Company.
Well, I got some help, but they interviewed me. They were writing some. I had a manuscript somewhat, and I went through and rewrote every page, every word.
Wow.
To make sure it was in this guy's writing.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I could understand it.
Yeah.
You know, and other people could understand it. People have heard me all my life, my wrestlers, my family, and they're going to say, that's not him. Well, not many people say, I can hear you talking when I read this book.
Well, you're going to have both books available at our library coming up on the 23rd at 2 o'clock. And you've kind of done the speaking circuit for a couple of years promoting the book. You go, do you go to other parts of the country or just primarily focus on Iowa?
I go wherever I can.
Yeah.
You know, people tried to get me to go to over in Russia. But I put my foot down sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I have gone other places. I haven't gone far enough because it needs to get out more. But I've been to New York City, I've been to Long Island, been to Denver. But, do it mostly in Iowa. And, so I'm going to come here to Marshalltown. I've been here for Marshalltown probably for book one. I haven't been here for book one and two.
Right.
And, you know, because I got a lot of tradition, I mean, a lot of history with Marshalltown, and I can, you know, give a little speech when I'm here to tell you about that, and it involves, you know, guys like Mike Mann, the wrestling coach, a guy named Bob Logan, who was here back in the 70s, that went to Alaska and coached, I don't know what he did up there, a guy named Adolf Rupp from Marshalltown that was a basketball guy,
yeah.
But he started the wrestling program here and won a state championship. You know, I got, got other people that... I got Matt Doyle, who was my trainer at the University of Iowa. He came here. Taylor's Made Right, I think that's here.
It is, yes.
I got a really big story in the book about Taylor's Made Right.
And
I don't know if it's in that one or book two, but I can't even remember. But that was one, you know what? That saved my life. That day that I went into Taylor's Made Right. Because if I'd ever ran and won for governor, I'd be dead now, you know, because I'm not a good politician.
Okay, so you got to get the book to hear the Taylor's Made Right story. We're with wrestling legend Dan Gable today. Hey, don't miss him at our library. He'll be there on the 23rd at 2 o'clock. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.